Hari Om Tat Sat. Welcome to Swami Jyotirmayananda Society, our journey to self-realization. Please subscribe for the mystical meanings and to enjoy daily satsang. We are currently exploring Srimad Bhagavad Gita, commentaries by Swami Jyotirmayananda Maharaj, narrated by myself, Swami Nikhilananda. So today we will be studying chapter number 10, starting from shloka number 16, where Arjuna is singing the glories of Lord Krishna. Arjuna continues, Vaktumaharasya Sheshena Divyahyatma Vibhutayaha Yabhir Vibhutir Bhir Lokan Manstavam Vapyatishthasi. Having pervaded these worlds by your divine glories, you alone can describe them fully. So all the worlds, all the cosmos, the Milky Ways, the galaxies, wherever our eyes and science can go, God is already present there in subtle form. Inside the atom that rotates the neutron, the proton, the energy that is making consciousness, making all of us act and react. So only God can then fully describe that glory. It is beyond everybody else's comprehension, because it is not something that we can achieve with our intellect or mind or senses or ego or our sense hands, our body. All those things are helpful tools, but they are not able to grasp God directly. Through these tools, we can get enlightened, we can get God, but through our intense self-effort. There is no recipe out there that can quickly get us to God realization. We have to earn it with our effort, with our sweat, just like you earn your doctor degrees or engineering degrees or professional qualifications. Much in the same way, we have to earn self-realization, but it is through your effort and God's grace. So moving on to shloka number 17. Katham vidyamaham yogim stvam sada parichintayana keshu keshu cha bhaveshu chintyo asi bhagavan maya. O yogin Krishna, how am I to know you? By constantly meditating upon you. O blessed Lord, in what various aspects of yours am I to dwell upon you? So now Arjuna, having realized the glory of Krishna, having heard all the glorifications, all the wonderful potential and creation of God, he now wants to know how to meditate upon God and how to know God. What is the best way to think about God? What a beautiful question, where we will also be helped by the Lord's responses. And the final shloka, Arjuna in his stuti says, Vistarenatmano yogam vibhutim cha janardana bhuyah kathaya triptirhi shrinavato nasti me mritam. O Janardana, Janardana is the controller god of the world, sought by all beings for the fulfillment of their desires. Krishna, please describe to me again your yoga or divine powers and vibhutis. Vibhutis are divine glories. That's what this 10th chapter is about, the divine glories of God, thus known as vibhuti yoga. For my ears are never satisfied hearing your nectarine words. So it is like amrita or nectar. Just like when we enjoy satsang, we want it to continue because it is such a feast for our souls. And Arjuna is feeling the same way. And now Lord continues. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Hantate Kathayishyami Divyahyatma Vibhutayaha Pradhanyataha Kuru Shrestha nastyanto vistarasya me. The blessed Lord said, "Very well, O Arjuna, the best among the Kurus, I will describe to you the most prominent of my divine glories, because there is no end to my glorious manifestations." As we were just discussing in yesterday's satsang, God's glories are in everywhere, in every atom. So God says, how can I explain everything to you? So therefore, let me summarize it, give you highlights of my key glories only. Then shloka 20, aham atma guda kesha sarva bhutashaya sthitaha aham adischa madhyam cha bhutanamanta eva cha. O guda kesha, meaning conqueror of sleep, Arjuna, I am the self seated in the heart of all living beings. I am also the beginning, the middle, and the end of all living beings. So beautiful shloka. God has started out saying, I reside in you meaning in each one of us, even in an ant, a plant, an insect, a tree, a cat, a dog. He's everywhere in everything. And he is also the cause of our beginning, our creation, and our exit, departure, finality of all beings. So therefore, everything, we are like the waves we within God, just like the ocean. In the ocean, the waves come and go back to the ocean. Much in the same way, we are the waves of God. we are visible and then we go and merge back in Him also. Shloka number 21. Adityanaham Vishnur Jyotisham Ravir Anshuman Marichir Marutamasmi Nakshatranamaham Shashi. I am Vishnu among the Adityas, the radiant sun among the luminaries, among the Marutas, spirits presiding over the wind. I am Marichi among the stars. I am the moon. So here God is confirming His existence in, like He said, in the major things that are glorifying the world. So Lord Vishnu, and here in the form of Lord Krishna, Krishna being the incarnation of God, God is saying, I am the Vishnu, and then the radiant sun, the wind, again in the stars, I am the moon. Next shloka, Vedanam Sama Veda Asmi, Devanam Asmi Vasavaha, Indriyanam Anash Asmi, Bhutanam Asmi Chetana. I am Sama Veda among the Vedas, Indra among the gods, the mind among the indriyas or senses of perception, and consciousness in living beings. So, all the essence in the Vedas, Samveda is the most melodious Veda, where it is generally chanted by singing. And in the gods, Indra is the leader or the god of the gods. And in the mind, in the senses, mind is the controller of the senses. So God says, then I am the mind and the consciousness of all living beings. Consciousness is that entity that makes us talk, walk, sleep, eat, think, act. Everything happens through that consciousness. The minute that consciousness exits our body, none of our organs work and we are declared dead, passed away, end of the game. So that is where God says He resides. Although He is residing in everything, but mind you, here He is giving only His key glories. Shloka 23, Rudranam Shankarashasmi, Vittesho Yaksharakshasam, Vasunam Pavakashasmi, Meruhu Shikharinamaham. Among the Rudras, I am Shankara. Among the Yakshas and Rakshasas, I am Kubera, the Lord of Wealth. Among the Vasus, I am Pavaka, the Fire God. And among the mountains, I am Meru. So again, different forms of creation, different aspects of creation, and God's existence in each of them. Shloka 24. Purodhasam cha mukhyam maam viddhi partha brihaspatim senani namaham skandaha sarasamasmi sagaraha. O Partha, O Arjuna, know me to be Brihaspati, who is the guru or the spiritual preceptor of the gods, among the divine priests, Skanda, Kartikeya, among the generals of the divine army, and the ocean among the expanses of water. So, this is continuing all the divine aspects. So, all the gods have also a guru, just like we have gurus and spiritual preceptors on earth. Indra also, and the gods in the heavens, their guru is Guru Brihaspati. So God says, Lord Krishna, in that I am in that form. And then among the commander-in-chiefs, I am Skanda or Kartikeya, who is the son of Lord Shiva. And in all the waters, I am ocean. Why? Because all the rivers merge into ultimately the ocean. Continuing Shloka 25. Maharshinam Bhriguraham Giram Ramye Kamaksharam Yajnanam Japa Yajyo Asmi Sthavaranam Himalayaha. I am Bhrigu among the great sages. I am the one syllable Om among words. I am Japa Yajna among sacrifices, and the Himalayas among the immovables. So here God is giving us different ways to reflect on Him, to think about Him. And here He says, among the sages, sage Bhrigu is one of the well-known sages. And then among the words, it's Om. That's why we always say Om Tat Sat, or we always start a satsanga with three Oms. Om is the cosmic Brahman, the energy, the consciousness, and God Himself is acknowledging that here. I am Om. And Japa Yajna. Japa is the mantra power. Power of the mantra is phenomenal. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Shri Radhaya Namah, Om Shri Krishnaya Namah, Om Shri Hanumate Namah, or simply Om. Oh, the mantras are extremely powerful, and He says, so when we are doing fire obligations or sacrifices in other ways, out of that, the Japa Yajna is the most adorable, most the highest, the essence. And the Himalayas among the immovables, as we all know, Himalayas are the highest mountain ranges in the world. And that's what God is saying, I am the Himalayas there. Moving. So we will conclude our satsang here, and we will start from shloka number 26 in tomorrow's satsanga. We are discussing Vibhuti Yoga. Hari Om Tat Sat.